Welcome to part two of our 35-day trek through the Nepali Himalaya.
If you missed part one, we'll wait for you. Go and watch it. If you've already seen it, carry on.
As for now, it's day 13 and our first day on the Annapurna Circuit. And it's lunchtime.
Yeah, what's for lunch?
Dal bhat.
We got here about 2 p.m. so it's nice to get somewhere early. Not a bad room, eh? Pretty light, pretty airy. First room of the Annapurna Circuit. If they're all like this, I'll be happy. It's even got a private bathroom. Show them the private bathroom. Anyway, time to get changed, go and drink some hot chocolate, and I really want to buy some woolly socks because my feet get cold at night and I don't have enough. I saw a wee shop up there, so we'll go do some shopping, eh, Del?
You can do some shopping. That apple, Kim?
I've never enjoyed an apple so much in my life.
Day 14 and day 2 on the Annapurna Circuit. We're heading from Chame to Pisang, Lower Pisang. We're going to today. Should be about 16 km. A little bit of up, a little bit of down. Mostly road. So far, it's been a bit of a disappointing day. Mostly just because we've been walking on road, which is, you know, not really what we're here to do. We went through that little bit of forest, which I'm like, oh, we're back in the forest, this is great. And then, before you knew it, we're on the gravel road. There was an apple farm. We bought some apples. They were delicious.
They were apple-licious.
They were golden delicious, to be exact. Anyway, this bit's quite cool. Another hour or so, it'll be Dal bhat o'clock.
We're having lunch at Disneyland, apparently.
Tracking as usual, no complaints. Thank you.
We're just trying to decide whether to stay here tonight or keep going to where we thought we were going to stay. Because it turns out Disneyland's food's quite good and it's quite nice to stay in somewhere where most people aren't staying so that the trail's quieter the next day. It's nice and warm here. We have all day. So I consulted the magic spoon and I conversed with the papad of prediction and we decided that we will check a room, see what it's like, and as long as it's good, we're going to stay here. I checked the room and it smells like fresh pine. It's glorious. Come see. Ta-da! A table, two beds, hooks on the wall so we can hang our stuff. That's a first. A light switch with charging point and a lot of fresh pine. What more could you ask for? Let's go check out the bathroom situation. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a sit-down toilet. It's been a while. And right next door, look at this. You can even attach it to the wall. That might seem like such a simple thing, but out of the two hot showers I have had on this trek, both of them, I've had to shower like this. Let's shower. Day 14, we have a slightly longer walk ahead of us today, maybe just an hour or so because we stopped early yesterday at this place and I am so glad that we did. This has been the nicest place we've stayed on the whole trek and had the best shower I've had in the whole of Nepal. Now we're going to take the slow road to Manang. We decided to break it up over 2 days. We're going a slightly less travelled route up to Ngawal, maybe about 5 hours today. Hopefully a little bit less busy and less roads. Hoping for some actual trail walking today. Are we nearly ready, Del?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
We made it up from Dhukur Pokhari, where we stayed last night, to the village of Ghyaru. We got here about 11:30, so not too late. Ordered lunch. It was a delicious dal bhat, but unfortunately it took about an hour and 15 to come, which is very unusual. Yesterday it came in 5 minutes.
At least we got to sit here in the sun looking at this view behind
exactly.
us.
Yeah, cracking views of the Annapurnas. The landscape's changed a lot today, and we've not really been on the road.
No roads.
No roads, mostly just path, which is really good because we were a bit cheesed off with the roads.
Yeah, and it has restored our faith in the Annapurna Circuit, basically.
Yeah, we're much happier about where we are today and about the trail. After this, we're going on to Ngawal, where we'll stay for the night. It's about an hour and a half away.
Narwhal.
Narwhal. Kim keeps saying narwhal. I don't think we're going to find any narwhals at 3,700 meters.
Disappointing. It's the only reason I wanted to go there.
Maybe I can pretend to be a narwhal. How about that?
I'd prefer that. Can you pretend right now?
What noise do they make?
I have no idea.
Good morning.
Day 16, and it is our fourth day on the Annapurna Circuit. We have had this cracking view right from our lodge room. We enjoyed it last night at sunset. We've been enjoying it all morning with breakfast.
It's a bit of a steep climb to come up here, but it's totally worth it. But today we're heading on to Manang. It should just be a few hours, and it's mostly a little bit downhill and easy road.
Yeah, we're going to stay there for 2 nights, so tomorrow is going to be a bit of a rest day. Mm-hmm. And they've got cinema! We can go to the cinema and eat
Kim's
popcorn.
Been going on about this cinema for days. Arrived in Manang and checked into the hotel Himalaya. We've actually just got the biggest room we've had on the whole trek. Got a double bed, got a single bed here as well to put all our stuff on. Tons and tons of room. Kim's testing out the shower just now. By the sounds that she's making, it's probably not that hot, which means I don't think I'll bother. This afternoon, we're going to go and check out the cinema, and there's a talk at the medical center. Sounds like it'll be quite interesting. We're going to go and take a look at that too.
Day 17, and it is our fifth day on the Annapurna Circuit, and today is our rest day. Nice. So what have we been doing, Dal?
We have been taking a leisurely morning. I did some washing,
Then we went for coffee and cake.
The coffee was good. Yesterday's cake was better.
And generally wandering around town. And yesterday, of course, we went to the altitude talk. That was a really, really, really good talk. We learned a lot of things, cleared up a lot of doubts,
misinformation
that had been flying around. If you're here in Manang, definitely go. It's on at 3 p.m. every day. It can kind of put your mind to rest about the whole altitude sickness thing. So we're just going to take it easy today. Just generally rest before we hit the trail again tomorrow.
It's day 18, day 6 on the Annapurna Circuit. We're heading from Manang up to Yatkarka today. It's going to be going over 4,000 meters for the first time since we came over the Larki Pass on the Manaslu Circuit. Getting a little colder, a little higher. My nose is running like a tap this morning. We had a nice couple of days in Manang, ready to head over the pass.
Nice short day. We made it to Yatkarka before 11:30. We've had our lunch and now we've got the rest of the day just to take it easy and relax.
They've got a nice little dining room, sitting room area. I'm looking forward to hanging out in there all day.
It's day 19, day 7 on the Annapurna Circuit. We've made it up to Thorong High Camp, the highest point that you can stay before you head over the Thorong Pass. Much like about a week ago when we went over the Larki Pass, we're going to be getting up tomorrow morning at 2:30, breakfast at 3:30, and then hitting the trail by about 4:15. To head up over that pass. It's going to take us about 3 hours to get to the top of the pass, I think.
It should be quite a gentle incline though, I think.
Yeah.
We did the tough bit today, to be honest.
I've seen a forecast. I don't really want to tell Kim how cold it's going to be, but...
How cold?
Maybe minus 11?
Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding you, no. So it's going to be really, 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 really cold. Baltic. Baltic. Bloody cold. How'd you feel, Kim?
Stomach feels crazy again. It is bitterly cold. My water hose is frozen. I can't drink water out of it. My hands and my toes are just like warming up and then freezing again.
Past Dalbat, Kim, how is it?
It's hot, which is exactly what I need right now. Sorry if I was a bit whingy up there. I've just literally never been that cold in my life for such a prolonged period of time. I mean, it was painful. I really couldn't enjoy the walk up because I was just so freaking cold.
Yeah, I couldn't feel my fingers or my toes.
And my bum, why was my bum so cold? Like freezing. Now I understand the expression freezing your arse off.
Day 20, and what day on the Annapurna Circuit?
Day 8 on the Annapurna Circuit.
Okay, there you go. And just like that, the biggest day is done. We crossed the Thorong Pass this morning, got into Muktinath about 1 o'clock, so a much better effort than our 12-hour day on the Larky Pass.
Much better, yeah.
Watch the boop.
I'm watching it. Pass itself, you know, not very difficult, quite gentle in most places.
Yeah.
A little bit steep coming down in some places, but mostly it was a not too difficult hike.
Yeah. Fortunately, neither of us had any sort of altitude sickness issues or anything like that. So that's us, we're now in Mustang.
It's day 21 and day 9 on the Annapurna Circuit. We are heading from Muktinath to Kagbeni today. Most people take the 3-hour journey on the busy road. Plenty of jeeps, motorbikes, and a lot of dust. We, on the other hand, crossed over the river and we're heading through some nice villages. Really, really nice walk. Lots of great views and no traffic. It takes about an hour or so longer, but it's well worth it, I think. Just great to be on a trail. Oh, Jesus Christ. So busy talking to the camera, just slipped into a big muddy puddle.
Yeah, dodo.
But you'll notice how quickly I recovered. That's good balance, people. Try that with 25 kilograms on your back.
He's so modest, isn't he? Humble Dell, that's what they call him.
Usually I'm pretty humble.
Day 22 and day 10 on the Annapurna Circuit. It's our last day before we head to the restricted area of Upper Mustang tomorrow.
It's kind of surprising that we've come to the end of our circuit trek already and part two of this trip. It's going quite fast, but looking forward to tomorrow. It should be very different scenery, Tibetan culture, influences in the architecture and so on, so we're excited about that.
Yeah, we've been looking forward to this part for a long time.
I'd still say that Manaslu, which was part one of our trek, was our favourite so far.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. The circuit's been good, but Manaslu still pips it. But anyway, do stick around for part three. If you haven't seen part one, you can go back and check it out as well. And if you've enjoyed this video, give us a like. You can drop us a comment below if you've got any questions. We're going to have full details about day-to-day itinerary, things like food and costs and the places that we've stayed and so on in the blog post over on our website. You can check the link in the description down below.
Subscribe to our channel to see all our videos and don't forget to hit that bell so you get a notification anytime we put up a new video.
Absolutely.
Otherwise you might miss them.
Right, thanks for watching.
Yeah.
See you next time.
Bye, see you in part three.